Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the delay line canceller of MTI radar, and we are also going to derive the equation for the same. So let's begin with the topic. In case of MTI radar, the MTI radar is basically a pulse radar and it uses a low pulse repetition frequency. MTI radar having a unique feature to distinguish between the received echo signal and stationary clutter. And by using that unique method, the MTI radar is able to make a difference between the moving object and the stationary object. Now, in this topic, we are going to discuss a delay line canceller for MTI radar. So, at the same time, we are also going to discuss the following points. And the points are single delay line canceller for clutter rejection, elaborate of sweep to sweep subtraction by delay line. Then we will have a discussion on the frequency response function of the delay line canceller, then block diagram of the delay line canceller and harmonics of the pulse repetition frequency. Now if we look at the circuit diagram or if we look at the block diagram of receiver section of MTI radar, then we will come to know that the delay line canceller is considered as one of the most important block of the MTI radar. The delay line canceller is basically used to delay the received frequency by a sweep so that there will be a difference between the received frequency and the transmitted frequency. And now that signal can be used to display the moving targets on the display. Now let's see the block diagram of delay line canceller. The figure shows block diagram of single delay line canceller, which is nothing but time domain filter. And in this case, the signal at the output of the phase detector is given by V1 is equals to k sine 2 pi fdt upon theta 0, where fd is the Doppler frequency shift. Now the term phi 0 is also given as that is called as constant phase, and it is given as 4 pi r0 upon lambda. Now k is called as amplitude of the signal. Now let's assume that the signal from previous transmission is delayed by a pulse TP, and therefore the signal is given as V2 is equals to k sine 2 pi fd into t minus TP minus phi 0. Now the delay line canceller subtract the two signal and we obtain signal as V is equals to V1 minus V2. We have the values of V1 and V2, and we are going to substitute this value to obtain the final value of the signal that is output of the delay line canceller. By using a trigonometric relation that is sine A minus sine B, that is sine A minus sine B is equals to 2 sine A minus B upon 2 into cos A plus B upon 2. We obtain value of V as so we obtain final equation as V equals to 2k sine pi fd tp into cos 2 pi fd into t minus tp by 2 minus phi 0. Now if we look at the previous equation of sine A minus sine B, then in this case we consider A as 2 pi fd t minus phi 0 and B is equals to so these are the values of A and B. So when we substitute the value in the formula of sine A minus sine B, we get the equation of V, that is 2k sine pi fd tp into cos 2 pi fd bracket t minus tp by 2 bracket over minus phi 0. So from the equation of V, we will come to know that the output of the delay line canceller consists of the cosine wave having magnitude of 2 pi fd t minus tp by 2. And we can also say that the output of the cancelled signal is depend upon the amplitude of the Doppler frequency shift, that is Ft, and amplitude of the pulse repetition frequency or pulse repetition time, that is Tp. Now, let's move to the frequency response of the delay line canceller. Now, in frequency response of delay line canceller, the amplitude is get divided by factor k, and it is given as so we can write the same equation in the form. So we obtain the equation that is frequency response function h of f is equals to 2 sine pi f d tp. Now the frequency response becomes 0 when we have the value of 2 pi f d tp as and therefore the value of f d becomes fd is equals to 2 vr upon lambda. Now the same equation can be represented in other terms and the equation becomes nfp. Now we are going to substitute the value of fp. Now we are going to substitute the value of fp as a reciprocal of time period and therefore the frequency fd becomes so value of fd is equals to n upon tp for values of n are considered as 0, 1, 2 and so on. So if the target is moving having Doppler frequency shift at pulse repetition frequency and its harmonics, then it may possible that the target may not be able to get detected by the radar system even if the target is present. And that is called as blind speed of target. The blind speed is considered as one of the serious issue in case of MTI radar. And therefore it is considered as one of the drawback or limitations of the MTI radar. So now let's move on to the radial velocity of moving target is given by we have again taken the equation that is FD is equals to 2 VR upon C. Now the equation becomes now FP is get replaced by reciprocal that is 1 upon TP. Now this equation can also be written in the form or that is in terms of FT as so therefore the TP is nothing but FT. So we can say NFP is nothing but 2FT VR upon C and therefore we can write so from this we can calculate the value of VR and the value of VR as n lambda fp upon 2. Now here the value of n starts from 1, 2, 3, 4 and not from 0. So n is become equal to so if we consider this radial frequency as a blind speed then we can say that VR is equals to VN is equals to N lambda F upon 2 and value of N becomes 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So if lambda is measurable then we can write so the equation in knots is given by V1KT is equals to 0.97 lambda in meter into frequency in hertz that is approximately equals to lambda FP upon 2. Now, the blind speed of target is considered as one of the major or serious issue in case of MTI radar because of the blind speed, it may possible that the target is get undetected by the radar system even if the target is actually present over the position. So, the blind speed position of target can be reduced or can be eliminated by using the following remedies and the points are so when we want to reduce the effect of blind speed of target in case of MTI radar then we need to operate the radar at low frequency that means at longer wavelength or else we can also operate the radar with high pulse repetition frequency or with multiple pulse repetition frequency or with more than one radio frequency. So by using this method we can eliminate the effect of blind speed target which occurs in case of MTI radar and because of that the target becomes undetectable even if the target is actually present at the location. So this is what about the delay line canceller and function of delay line canceller in case of MTI radar. Now let's move to the multiple choice question and the first question is The delay line canceller acts as, first of all, high pass filter waveguide. Option B is digital subtractor circuit. Option C is time domain filter, and option D is broadband filter. A single delay line canceller acts as a time domain filter, and therefore we can say option C is considered as a right option. Now let's move to the next question. The frequency response of delay line canceller is constant amplitude. Option A is constant amplitude sinusoidal variation, a cosine constant variation. Option C is Bessel function, and option D is linear amplifier response. So we can say option B is considered as the right option for the question, that is the frequency response of delay line canceller is a cosine constant variation. So this is what about the delay line canceller of MTI radar, which plays an important role in the receiver of the MTI radar. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.